Hello again, and welcome back to another review. And this time, Sean and I are here to review the movie Date Night. Date Night just opened today on April 9th, 2010, and it stars television big-time stars Tina Fey and Steve Carell. It comes to us from comedic director Sean Levy, director of the Pink Panther movies with Steve Martin and the Night at the Museum movies with Ben Stiller. Sean, she's here to tell us a little bit about the film.
Thank you, Nick. Date Night is a story of Phil Foster and Claire Foster, played by Steve Carell and Tina Fey, who play a nice, normal married couple who's basically going through the paces of life, wouldn't you say?
Like a midlife kind of crisis
thing. Yeah, they have normal date nights where they go out to the local restaurant, and they play like an interesting game at the local restaurant.
Yes, they make fun of the other couples,
and they tell stories what they think they are, and that's
kind
of funny.
Right.
But one day, their best friends decide to split up because their life has become stale.
So they want
to
shake things up a little bit.
So they want to shake things up. So Steve Carell's character decides to take them into the city to go to one of the big, expensive restaurants.
And then it reminded me of North by Northwest. He takes somebody's reservation.
Yes.
It's a lot like a...
The Triple Horns. Reservations.
And then because of this...
Because they could get a good table. Because they would ride there on Friday night at like 7:30.
Right.
Expecting the table. And
right.
Of course, you know you ain't going to get them.
Well, these crooks, just like in North by Northwest, these terrorists...
They're looking for the triple horns.
So they get caught up and they get ensued into this wild, wacky, what you'd call adventure, reminiscent of the out-of-towners with Goldie Hawn and Steve Martin.
They don't know that until they're pulled to the back alley. They just think that they got caught by the restaurant.
Right. But like I said, it does ensue that there's a lot of wild and wacky stuff that goes on. Now, did you like this movie or did you not like this movie?
I like that Steve Carell and Tina Fey actually portrayed like a believable married couple.
Okay.
That they didn't go too over the top with it. You could actually believe that these two people were married. And they didn't turn Steve Carell into a big action hero like in a normal movie like this.
Like Get Smart
or something. Like he'd be carrying around a gun. He does have a gun in here, but it doesn't do anything.
Right.
That's
I think this is absolutely one flat movie. I think it falls flat from the beginning to end. I think these are very smart actors. These are
very smart writers.
And this movie is not smart at all. There's so many wasted characters. This movie's only 88 minutes long. It's one of the longest 88 minutes I've spent at the movies.
No.
Oh, my God.
It is a solid comedy across the board.
I don't think so. I think to call this movie middle of the road is to bestow compliments of grounds it never even comes close to.
You are being way too hard on this film.
No.
What about Mark Wahlberg?
Mark Wahlberg is the only good thing
about this film. He plays a shirtless
He plays Mark
expert.
Wahlberg. He plays Mark Wahlberg. And
the scene when they knock on his door, that's hilarious. Steve Carell's facial reactions to just with Mark Wahlberg sitting there and seeing his wife react to him, that is hilarious.
I think,
is a great scene.
I think this movie falls flat on every time. What about the scene where they get connected to the cab?
I will agree with you on the car chase. The car chase scene did not belong in this film
at all. It's so ridiculous.
But we also got to bring up when they find the real Triple Horns. That's hilarious. When they find James Franco.
Right, okay.
And he has a hilarious scene with Steve Carell, the banter that they have back and forth. That's hilarious.
I did like that little part of it. In my opinion, I'm talking about a few... I did laugh, but you know what? I laughed a few times during The Deer Hunter, too. So, I mean, come on. There are comedic parts in every movie. I just expect the bar to be much higher when you're talking about the talents of Tina Fey. She's head writer on Saturday Night Live Steve Carell. Helped write the 40-year-old version for him to be part of this.
They both had solid, funny lines in this film. They weren't one supporting
flat.
The other. They were both,
It was not flat. I felt most of the humor in this film was uncomfortable. It made the audience feel uncomfortable. I thought that the dancing scene, I thought she was going to have to reach for the air tank. She was laughing so hard. The dancing scene at the end, I didn't like that at all. I really liked most of this movie. I just was... And I want to class it. I look at the talent that makes this movie, and I am so disappointed in this.
I will say that a couple performances were wasted. Mark Ruffalo has...
Three lines.
Ray Liotta
has five lines.
Ray Liotta's totally wasted as the mob boss.
Common is the taxi cab driver. He's in one scene.
Like I said,
William Fichtner has like three lines.
Now,
I don't know.
I liked him with his broom on his press conference. You didn't laugh at that.
I'm sure
he's going to sweep up crime.
I don't know. All I can say is when you go see a movie like this, I'm thinking I'm going to laugh from start to finish. I'm going to belly laugh a few times. I didn't belly laugh at all. I kind of smiled.
There's enough
movie.
Laughs in this film to recommend it. And we get so few comedies that are solid comedies nowadays.
And this isn't one of them.
This is one of them, folks.
And this definitely is not a solid comedy.
This is going to be like Shutter Island. We're going to have to let the folks out there decide what they think. I think it is worth your money.
How many stars?
I'm going to give this 3 stars.
You've got to be kidding me.
3 stars, Nick. What do you think about that?
listen, I'm going to bang the question. Did you watch the movie?
I watched the movie and I enjoyed this movie thoroughly.
I'm going to give this movie 1.5 stars. I laughed a few times. I think he's
it's
being
a solid comic,
so generous with this
no,
movie.
No, I think
it's
he's
one
been
of,
way too
it's
hard
one of
on
the
that.
Longest 88 minutes of your life.
Nick's been a little bit under the weather lately,
no,
I think. Maybe he's taking the wrong cough medicine or something.
That has nothing to do with this. and with his review, I'm thinking he's been taking too much NyQuil.
No, no. Folks, this is a solid comedy. Let us get the feedback from our fans out there.
Once again, he couldn't be further from the truth. All right. And... what are you going to wrap this up as? 3 stars?
We are.
He's going to wrap this up as 3 stars. I'm going to say 1.5 stars. And even though we disagree, remember, people.
We're not always right.
Only when it comes to the movies.
I'm right this time.
And no, he's still wrong. And thank you for your attention.
Thank you.